everybody, and welcome back to our channel, Nessa and Sophie. My name is Nessa, and this here is my Cavapoo puppy named Sophie. And I've come to the realization that I've talked about grooming a lot on this channel, but I've never actually shown you guys how to groom your Cavapoo puppies. So today I'm going to show you guys all the tools that you need and what the best way is to groom your Cavapoo puppy so that it's quick, it's painless, and basically so that you have a Cavapoo that has no knots or tangles. So let's get started. Now, in terms of tools, you only really need two essentials. You need a stainless steel comb and you need a slicker brush. That's really all that you need. But you may find that as you kind of get used to combing your Cavapoo and seeing whether they have a curlier or wavier coat, you may need some more tools. So every time I comb Sophie, I use both of these. I also have a pair of baby scissors, and I'll show you how I'll use those as well. And then I've recently gotten her this new BioSilk brush. It's got different kinds of bristles. It's got both soft and hard bristles. And I'm going to show you how I use each of these tools in order to make sure that Sophie has a beautiful tangle-free coat. The first tool I'll use is this new BioSilk brush. What this brush does is it goes over and gets all the big tangles and knots out first before I go in with the stainless steel brush and the slicker brush. It's also really important anytime that you introduce anything new to your puppy that you let them sniff it, check it out. And now what I'll just go ahead and do, thank you for the kisses. All I do is just comb lightly over the top of her hair. I won't use this brush for her underside. I'll only use it for her neck, her head, her back, and her paws. I won't use this on her underside because I find she doesn't get tangled as easily underside. And I also find that this works better on the skin here that's less sensitive. Her underside is very sensitive and she also doesn't like being on her back for very long. So next up is the stainless steel comb. What I really like about the stainless steel comb is that it'll get any of the knots or tangles that she has out. I know you like eating it. Before I use the slicker brush, what's really nice about this is that if you find any mats, you can also get those out with the stainless steel comb, and it's easier and less painful for her than the slicker brush. And same thing with the comb. I'll only use the comb on her back, on her top side, on her head, on her paws, and on her bum. I won't use the comb underneath her because it's way too sensitive. What's really nice about the stainless steel comb is that it allows me to get all these big tangles out before coming in with the slicker brush, because I find that the slicker brush really pulls at her skin if there's a knot. So I find the stainless steel comb is a great option to go in beforehand. Look how curly her butt is. Her butt is so curly. And I also find this is where she gets the most tangled because she's always sitting and wagging her tail when she's outside, wherever. So I find there's a lot of friction. So with the curls and the friction, it gets extra tangled back here. I know, I'm almost done. I know. With Sophie's tail, because she has a straight tail, I like to hold the hair at the bottom of the strands and then gently pull the brush up through the top towards the ends so that it doesn't pull on her skin or on the hair follicle. The next stage in grooming is going to be using your slicker brush. This is probably where you're going to spend the longest amount of time with grooming. It's just such a thorough tool that you're going to have to take a while just to make sure you get all those tangles out of your puppy's fur. And usually what I do, I'm sorry, Sophie is falling asleep and it's so cute. Usually what I'll do is I'll comb Sophie's head, then after I'll comb her ears, I'll do the back of her neck, I'll do her body, then I'll go onto her bum and her tail. And then after that, I will comb her neck, but I'll put her standing up for that. And I'll do her paws and her underside. Favorite part to comb Sophie is her ears. I love combing her ears. They also get very tangled as well. I find with Sophie, there are three areas where she gets really tangled. The fur around her neck, the fur on her bum and on her tail from all that friction, and then also the fur on her paws. It's really important to also remember that you need to comb your Cavapoo's face, especially the hair around their snout and underneath their snout, and even the little hair in between their eyes. Another important tip to remember is if your puppy is lying down on one side, focus on just combing all the available hair and space that you have on the other side, Don't worry so much about having to do both sides at the same time, because then you're just moving them around a lot. They'll get a lot more agitated. And like this, she's nice and comfy, so I'll just work on the area that I can reach while she relaxes.
Look how relaxed she is.
And you can see that because I used the stainless steel comb beforehand. Look at that. There's no tangles now in her tail because I already went and got all the big tangles out. So you guys can see that's just the top hair. So this is his head, top of the body, and paws. That's about as much hair that we've collected. Not too bad today. There it is. Sophie always loves sniffing it after I take it out. So there you go. There's all the combing for the top side. We've done all of her paws. We have done her bum. I am going to now have to flip her to do her underside. But the thing is, I know that usually really irritates her. She does not like being on her back whatsoever. So I'm going to take advantage of the fact that she's sleepy, and I'm going to cut her tear stains so that we don't have to worry about those. If you have a Cavapoo or a dog that struggles with tear stains, I did a video all about how to maintain and prevent tear stains. I'll include the link down below in the description box. You guys can check it out if you want more information on how I maintain Sophie's tear stains. There you go. All done. This is one of the reasons why I'll use the scissors. It's for cutting her tear stains, and it's also in case I find like a really bad knot that I can't take out with the slicker brush and I don't want to pull out her skin. It's also really important to remember too, when you're combing your dog, is to give them lots of praise and to tell them they're a good girl. And with Cavapoos, they love eye contact. As you can see right now, Sophie is giving me a lot of eye contact. Also, treats are really good too. Sophie doesn't really eat too many treats when I'm combing her just because she's gotten so used to it. But definitely if you have a reactive dog or a puppy who's still getting used to it, use lots of treats. Use them to your advantage. Okay, now I'm gonna flip Sophie and we're gonna do her underside. She does not like getting combed on her underside. Sophie is very sensitive with the hair and the skin down around her lower region. As you can tell, she's trying to escape me. And I try to do this as quickly as possible because I know she really doesn't like it. And I try to give her lots of praise and I try to do some breaks, but it needs to be done and she really doesn't like it. And I feel so bad, but I can't go without combing it. She's literally just hiding away. But look at that. Good girl, puppy. So for some odd reason, she's decided to tuck her head away behind me in the couch. But that's okay. I can still get down here and get to her lower region. She doesn't seem to be minding it too much. And there we go. We're all done. Sophie, are we all done?
You literally went as far away from me as possible.
There you go. That is how you groom a Cavapoo. Sophie is just over a year old, so she's had a lot of time to get used to being groomed. She still really does not like her paws or her underside being combed, even though I've trained her for a really long time with that stuff, but I guess there's just something she's just not comfortable with. I spent about 40 minutes grooming her today, and I'll do this about every 3 days, so just know that if you have a Cavapoo or are planning on adopting a Cavapoo, you will need to spend quite a bit of time grooming them just to make sure you avoid any tangles or knots. If you're interested in trying out any of the tools that I've used today with Sophie, I'll include the link for those down in the description box. You're more than welcome to check those out. And just remember too that these tools are what works really well for me and Sophie. If you have a Cavapoo that may have a curlier coat, you may require more tools than the ones we use. So that'll all depend on your Cavapoo and what you require in order to get a nice tangle-free coat. I really hope that this video was informative and helpful for anyone that wants to know how to groom a Cavapoo. If you have any other video requests on things you'd like to see Sophie do or even more information on Cavapoos, please send a message down below and I'll check those out. Thank you so much for watching and please don't forget to subscribe so you can support our channel and so you can see more. Thanks so much for watching. Bye guys.
Sophie, you wanna say bye?
Say bye. Bye.